girls in the hot tops dancing for days. Guys in the gold pants talking new slang, rolling through cities like a storm. Kids on the corner shaking spray paint, making their mark on the interstate. Drum piece sounds, cause life is beautiful. No ties, no fear, we're living in the minute. We came, we saw, not stopping till we get it. Just love. Voice. Making headlines just for kicks, trying to get love, not trying to get rich. We're the new Bohemian, we're the new Bohemian. Not in it for the fame, we do it for the thrill. Gonna light it up, wanna change the world. We're the new Bohemian, we're the new Bohemian.
Let's get going. So, question one. Who do you think you are kidding, Mr. Hitler? Is the starting line to which TV show's theme tune? So, who do you think you are kidding, Mr. Hitler? Is the starting line to which TV show's theme tune? Found the source of the hum. Question two, what was the name of the cafe owner in A Low, A Low? So what was the name of the cafe owner in A Low, A Low? Number three, The Big Breakfast launched in 1992 with Gabby Roslin and which other host? So The Big Breakfast launched in 1992 with Gabby Roslin and which other host? Question four, what was the name of the MI5 BBC drama that launched in 2002 and ran for 10 series? So what was the name of the MI5 BBC drama that launched in 2002 and ran for 10 series? Question five, who wrote Killing Eve? So who wrote Killing Eve? So if you have just joined us and you've missed the first few questions, you can rewind, you can go back to the start of the questions. Question six. Matt Damon was left for dead on Mars in which movie? So Matt Damon was left for dead on Mars in which movie? Question seven. Jamie Bell played the lead role in which British 2000s dance film? So Jamie Bell played the lead role in which British 2000s dance film? Question eight. Released in 1995, what was the name of the first completely computer animated film? So released in 1995, what was the name of the first completely computer animated film? Number 9. What was the name of the tower in Die Hard, the first one? Christmas movie. So what was the name of the tower in Die Hard? And finally, for TV and film, question 10. Liza Minnelli starred in which 1972 musical that was set in 1930s Berlin? So just so you're aware, we're just over 100 and, well, you can see it before me, but there's 177,000 people, which beats our own individual record. But yeah, that'll be a great record. Round 2. It's your sport and leisure round, and we kick off with this. Who scored England's last second winning drop goal in the 2003 World Cup final against Australia? So who scored England's last second winning drop goal in the 2003 World Cup final against Australia? Oh yeah, rugby union. That would make more sense. Yeah, so it's rugby union. I am pushing it as close to 30 seconds as I can. I've got a timer in the corner. Question 2. The Olympics have been rearranged to next year, but which month will they start? Is it May, June, or July? So the Olympics have been rearranged to The Olympics have been rearranged to next year, but what month will they start in? Is it May, June, or July? So which month will they start? Question 3. Who's won the most golf majors? So who's won the most majors in golf? Is it Tiger Woods or Jack Nicholson? It's not Jack Nicholson, it's Jack Nicklaus. There we go, first one of the night. It's not Jack Nicholson, it's supposed to be Nicholas. So who has won the most majors in golf, Tiger Woods or Jack Nicklaus? Nicholson. And he's off. If you watch the beer round on Wednesday, I gave away one of the answers. So I'll give you both answers to that, because obviously one of them's a bit obvious. Number 4. How many players are there on a standard volleyball team? How many players are there on a standard volleyball team? Question 5. The boat race takes place between which two universities? So the boat race takes place between which two universities? And you've got to get both for the point, because a lot of people were asking me to mediate on them. So you need both for the point. So the boat race takes place between which two universities? Number six. Which board game has a cheaters and an ultimate banking edition? So which board game has a cheaters and an ultimate banking edition? Question seven. Becoming is a 2018 book written by whom? So Becoming is a 2018 book written by whom? Question eight. Defying Gravity is a song from which musical? So Defying Gravity is a song from which musical? Number nine, which UK city is the home of the National Rail Museum? So which UK city is the home of the National Rail Museum? Finally, for sports and leisure, number 10. In which board game would you find Miss Scarlet and Professor Plum? So in which board game would you find Miss Scarlet and Professor Plum? So that is your sports and leisure round. We've got one final round and something to tell you about, and then take a short break so you can put all your answers together. Let's go with your music. Number one. Which boy band returned after a 10-year hiatus in 2019 with their hit, Hello My Love? So which boy band returned after a 10-year hiatus in 2019 with their hit, Hello My Love? Number two, what is Stormzy's real first name? So, what is Stormzy's real first name? Question three. Who said we could stand under her umbrella? In 2007. So who said we could stand under her umbrella in 2007? Number four, according to the title of the song, who did Katy Perry kiss in 2008? So according to the title of the song, who did Katy Perry kiss in 2008? Number five, who is Reginald Dwight better known as? Question six. She's got a brother. We don't get on with one another. But I quite fancy her mother, and I think that she likes me. Name the Oasis song. So she's got a brother. We don't get on with one another. But I quite fancy her mother, and I think that she likes me. So name the Oasis song. Question seven, Whitney Houston wanted to dance with who in the 80s? So what was the name of that song? Whitney Houston wanted to dance with who in the 80s? Number eight, What's Love Got to Do with It was an 80s hit for whom? So What's Love Got to Do with It was an 80s hit for whom? Number nine, Stairway to Heaven was a 1971 hit for whom? So Stairway to Heaven was a 1971 hit for whom? And finally then, question 10. Each morning I get up and die a little, can barely stand on my feet. Name the song. Forgot to put that bit in. But each morning I get up and die a little, can barely stand on my feet. Name the song. Okay, so that is the first part of the quiz. We're up to 182,000 people watching live, which is just an incredible amount of people. That's beaten all of the, this is the biggest week then so far. Our record before that, personal record, was 175 before that. So well on our way to getting a world record with this. So as I say, I'll keep you posted as we keep going. So just before I put all the hold up music and everything, this is the thing I've been more nervous about talking about. And a lot of you have got to know me through videos and stuff, through Facebook and bits and pieces I talk about on here. And I mean, I used to run a pub up until March with my business partner. We gave it up for financial difficulty and went back into the real world. And then I set this virtual pub quiz up, which if you're playing the drinking game, local quiz for local people, and it exploded beyond anything that I ever thought. It was supposed to be 40 to 50 people, and you know, there's 182,000 now sat watching, which is just an incredible amount. And it's consumed everything. It's consumed every part of my life. And you know, obviously I still make time for family, etc., but I'm currently on unpaid leave from work because I started complications. But what this has now given me is a thought and a taste for actually pursuing this as a career. A lot of you have been saying we want this to carry on after the lockdown, and a lot of you have been saying, you know, come and see us in our pubs, and Alex and I have been saying about, you know, it'd be great to go out and do a tour. And this is the reason I'm struggling with this is because I don't ask people for help. My mum, you know, anyone who knows me well, I don't put my hand up, and I never say, oh, can you help me? I'll always help everyone else out. So with a lot of encouragement from Alex, from Jenny, who I've been talking to as well, from friends and family, they've said, why not set up something, which I have, and I'll talk about it in a sec, and just see. And what it will enable me to do is to forget about my day job that I've got now, and this becomes my day job. And it means, with all the different options on there, it means that I can pursue this. I can pursue this as a career. I can keep this going after lockdown to keep entertaining you. I can keep investing everything. I can keep making this as better, but to keep it as grounded as it is. What you've come here, the 180,000 of you that have come here to watch. So with all of that and all their encouragement, I've set up what's called a Patreon account. Now, some of you watching may already know what that is, but I'll explain it. And I want to clarify from the start, the quizzes will stay free no matter what. Even if you're not, you know, you have a look and you think, well, I can't help, I don't mind, it's not what I'm asking. So the Patreon account, there's five different tiers. It starts from £3 a month and goes through the tiers. What I've committed to with that as well is, and it says it on all of the tiers on the site, a portion of that will still be donated to charity out of what comes in, because I still think charity is massive at heart of that. Look at what we raised as a group of £133,000 for the NHS. So I want that to continue. But the difference with the Patreon is you guys will vote. I'll put it out to a vote as to where the charity donation every month will go, and that'll be your decision. And there'll be some exclusives and all sorts of bits and pieces. I need to stop talking, because it's really hard for me to be asking this. So I'm going to put the details up on screen. I've got to take a break now anyway, just so I can change some things over. So it's a bit of a longer break. Have a look through your answers. Alex is probably mithering me, saying don't forget that the questions are up on social media if you need them. The link and everything for the Patreon site will go up now. If you can help, fantastic. It's not just me, we'll be helping the charities as well that you'll pick. If you can't, don't worry. I'm not going to start charging for the quiz. The quizzes will still stay free. But if you can in any way help, it will make this an incredible career that you guys have helped create. So thank you very much. I will see you in about 10 minutes' time. 30 seconds and we'll get you all sorted for... and if you were still trying and what have you, you know, the link's going to be there. It'll be in the description and what have you down below, etc. So if you know, if you do want to go across, thank you so much. We've got a Guinness record to get as well here. So let's get you the answers then for your first three rounds. Let's start with round one. And number one. So who do you think you are kidding, Mr. Hitler, is the starting line to which TV show's theme tune? It was Dad's Army. Who do you think you are kidding, Mr. Hitler, if you're thinking it? Anyway, number two. What was the name of the cafe owner in Allo Allo? It was René. I'm not 100% sure I should have watched that as a kid, because it was. I've watched them recently, and yeah. Anyway, number three. The Big Breakfast launched in 92 with Gabby Roslin, and which other host? It was Chris Evans. Number three, what was the name of the MI5 BBC drama that launched in 2002 and ran for 10 series? It was Spooks. Just started watching that again. Forgot how good that was. Really, really good. Question five, who wrote Killing Eve? It was Phoebe Waller-Bridge. Another great fundraiser for the NHS. I think she raised, did she raise over $1 million? I think, I was reading the other day. Number six, Matt Damon was left for dead on Mars in which movie? It was The Martian. Number seven, Jamie Bell played the lead role in which British 2000s dance film? It was Billy Elliot. Went from stage to screen? Or the other way around? Number eight, released in 1995, what was the name of the first completely computer animated feature film? It was Toy Story. And it was also Pixar's first as well. Number nine, what was the name of the tower in Die Hard? It was the Nakatomi Plaza. And finally, number 10, Liza Minnelli starred in which 1972 musical? It was Cabaret. Round two, sports and leisure. Number one, who scored England's last second winning drop goal in 2003? It was Johnny Wilkinson. Number two, the Olympics have been rearranged to next year, but which month, excuse me, which month will they start? It is July. Number three, who has won the most majors in golf? Tiger Woods or, well, let's start with this one first. So who's won the most majors in golf? Tiger Woods or Jack Nicholson? It says Jack Nicholson, but it's not. He's never won a golf major in his life. It's actually Tiger, obviously with that one, it'd be Tiger Woods. But if you were looking for the Tiger Woods or Jack Nicholas, it is Jack Nicholas. So, yeah. So you wouldn't get these mistakes. Oh, that's me. Wouldn't get these mistakes with a professional quiz host now, would you? Question four. How many players on a standard volleyball team? It is six. Question five. The boat race takes place between which two universities? It's Oxford and Cambridge. And I said I'd mediate on this, so you need both for the point. Number six, which board game has a cheaters and an ultimate banking edition? It is Monopoly. Number seven, Becoming is a 2018 book written by whom? It was Michelle Obama. Number eight, Defying Gravity is a song from which musical? It was Wicked. Which UK city is the home of the National Rail Museum? It is York. And finally, number 10. In which board game would you find Miss Scarlet and Professor Plum? It is Cluedo. And then on to your music round. Number one, which boy band returned after a hiatus, a 10-year hiatus even, in 2009? It was Westlife. Number two, what is Stormzy's real first name? It's Michael. I think Michael Stormzy has a good ring to it. Number three, who said we could stand under an umbrella? It was Rihanna. Number four, according to the title of the song, who did Katy Perry kiss in 2008? It was a girl. Number five, who is Reginald Dwight, better known as? It is Elton John, Sir Elton John. Number six, she's got a brother. We don't get on with one another, but I quite fancy a mother, and I think that she likes me is the Oasis song. It is She's Electric. She's got a family full of eclectics. Number seven, Whitney Houston wanted to dance with who in the 80s? It was somebody. Number eight, What's Love Got to Do with It? Was an 80s hit for Tina Turner. Number nine, Stairway to Heaven was a 1971 hit for whom? It was Led Zeppelin. And finally, number 10, Each Morning I Get Up and Die a Little, Can Barely Stand on My Feet, is Somebody to Love by the incredible Queen. Okay, so if you want to just tot your scores up, let us know how you've got on so far. Obviously, I've not got the live chat on. I apologise, it was out of reach. But yeah, let us know how you've got on social media. I will give you a minute if you're handing your sheets back, etc., like you would do in a pub. We've got food and drink and general knowledge to come. And I've also remembered your tiebreaker if you need it. And I've also remembered to put the slides in the right order this week as well, so you don't get the answer straight away. Okay. 20 seconds. Let's get this record. How many have we got? We've got 181,000 people still with us. Superb. I know a lot of people are behind. So if you're playing behind, welcome along to this part of the quiz when you catch up. Right, let's get going. Food and drink, round four, question one. In the USA, it is known as an eggplant, but what is it called in the UK? So in the USA, it is known as an eggplant, but what is it called in the USA? In the UK. So in the USA, it's known as an eggplant, but what is it called in the UK? Number two, en croûte means what in French? So en croûte means what in French? Number three, which sweet wanted us to taste the rainbow? So which sweet wanted us to taste the rainbow? Question four, which UK beer has a blue five-pointed star on its label? So which UK beer has a blue five-pointed star on its label? Number five, what is the main seasoning, and I say the main seasoning, of goulash? Now I know a lot of you might make it in a different way, but there is a specific main seasoning that I found when I searched earlier. So what is the main seasoning of goulash? Number six, what is the world's most manufactured drink? So what is the world's most manufactured drink? Number seven. Now you need all of these for the point if I'm mediating. So what are the three main ingredients you would need to make a mocha? So what are the three main ingredients you would need to make a mocha? And I'm not talking sugar. What are the three main ingredients? Number eight, how would you make the drink snake bite? So you need two things to make it. How would you make the drink snake bite? Number nine, what is unusual about a lawn sausage in Scotland? Probably worded that the wrong way around, haven't I? What is unusual about the Scottish lawn sausage? Or the lawn sausage in Scotland? Works both ways. It's very nice. And finally, for round four, number 10, what does gin get its predominant flavour from? So what does gin get its predominant flavour from? One thing I'd love to do is actually make gin from scratch, but apparently it's highly illegal in this country. After I looked, you have to pay a lot to HMRC. So we won't be doing that. Okay, so that's the end of your food and drink round. You know what's coming? It's round five, it's general knowledge. Let's get you going then with question one. What is the highest number used in standard Sudoku? So what is the highest number used in standard Sudoku? Number two, where in the world would you expect to find a car with the vehicle registration code V? You may have used this question already this week, but where in the world would you expect to find a car with the vehicle registration code V? Question three. The logo for which popular app consists of a white telephone in a white speech bubble on a green background? So which the logo for which popular app consists of a white telephone in a white speech bubble on a green background? Number four, what was the name of the fourth book in the Harry Potter series? So what was the name of the fourth book in the Harry Potter series? Number five, moonshine was a slang term for what kind of beverage? So moonshine was a slang term for what kind of beverage? You don't need to go too specific on this. I mean, you can do, but you don't have to. Number six, who was the last UK act to win Eurovision? So who was the last UK act to win Eurovision? Number seven, true or false? The Bahamas is made up of 700 individual islands. So true or false, the Bahamas is made up of 700 individual islands. Number eight, the World Health Organization is based in which city? So the World Health Organization is based in which city? Number nine, Blue Moon, Hopelessly Devoted to You and Summer Nights. Are songs from which musical? So Blue Moon, Hopelessly Devoted to You and Summer Nights are songs from which musical? And your last question of the night, unless you need the tie break. Number 10. In the Bible, who built the ark? So in the Bible, who built the ark? And that's your quiz for tonight. So I'll give you a few minutes so that you can just confer your answers if you're playing in a team or if you're playing against each other and you want to make sure you've got everything right. Let's give Alex something to do because he's been a bit quiet for the last part of the quiz. So let's give him something to do. So if you want to let us know how you're getting on, hit the hashtag on Twitter and Insta or put loads of pictures up and he has to go through them. So let's give Alex something to do in the break. We'll give you 5 minutes. What are we now time-wise? 9:08. So yeah, we'll give you 5 minutes and we'll be back. I want that one back shortly. So in the USA, it is known as an eggplant, but what is it called in the UK? It's an aubergine. Number two, en croûte means what in French? It's pastry. There you go, live chat's back up. So en croûte means pastry, in pastry. Number three, which sweet wanted us to taste the rainbow? It is Skittles. Number four, which UK beer has blue five-pointed star on its label? It is Nuki Brown, or Newcastle Brown Ale if you want the full name. Nuki Brown. Number five, what is the main seasoning of goulash? It is paprika. I know there's others in there, but that is the main one. Number six, what is the world's most manufactured drink? It's tea. Number seven, what are the three main ingredients you would need to make a mocha? So I said I'm mediating, you need all three if you want the point. It is espresso, but if you've put coffee, that's fine. Hot milk and chocolate. So espresso, coffee, hot, espresso, yeah, what it says. Number eight, how would you make the drink snake bite? Well, it's half lager and half cider. Number nine, what is unusual about a lawn sausage in Scotland? It is square. Square sausage. Very nice. And number 10, what does gin get its predominant flavour from? It's juniper berries. Round five, your general knowledge. Number one, what is the highest number used in standard Sudoku? It is 9. Number two, where in the world would you expect to find a car with a vehicle registration code V? It stumped Jeremy Vine, but it's Vatican City. Number three, the logo for which popular app consists of a white telephone in a white speech bubble on a green background? It is WhatsApp. Number four, what was the name of the fourth book in the Harry Potter series? It was The Goblet of Fire. Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire, if you want to go specific. Number five, moonshine was a slang term for what kind of beverage? So it's an alcohol. I know a lot of people might go, well, bourbon or whiskey is where it started, but it ended up being the slang term for alcohol. Number six, who was the last UK act to win Eurovision? It was Katrina and the Waves back in 1997. Will we ever win again? I very much doubt it. Number seven, true or false, the Bahamas is made up of 700 individual islands. It's true. Number eight, the World Health Organization, is based in which city? I've not put the answer on. I'm gonna say Geneva on top of my head, but let me just find my notes. That's two question slides I've messed up tonight. Where are we? Yeah, Geneva. I thought it was, just wanted to make sure. So the World Health Organization is based in Geneva. Blue Moon, Hopelessly Devoted to You, and Summer Nights are in Greece. And finally, number 10. In the Bible, who built the ark? It was Noah. So that is your 50 questions and your quiz tonight. So, tiebreak. Who needs a tiebreak? Let's put it up on screen now. The highest residence in Europe is at the Shard in London, but at what height is it? In feet, what height is the highest residence? So the highest residence in Europe is at the Shard in London, but at what height is it in feet? Okay. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And your answer is 735 feet. It's the highest residence in Europe, based at the Shard in London. And that is the end of the quiz for this evening. Yeah, it's been a surreal evening, as have been the last sort of 6 weeks with all of this. So yeah, thank you very much. Thank you for all coming along, firstly, for tonight. I will get everything put together. We will get it. Let's run away from uninspired lies and find our place to get
girls in the hot tops dancing for days. Guys in the gold pants talking new slang, rolling through cities like a storm. Kids on the corner shaking spray paint, making their mark on the interstate. Drum beat sounds, cause life is beautiful. No ties, no fear, we're living in the minute. We came, we saw, not stopping till we get it. Just love, just lie, we'll start a revolution. In waves, we crash, one voice. Making headlines, just for kids. Trying to get love, not trying to get rich. We're the new.
come sit around.